The first time I went to England to play, which was in 88, I can assure you, the first clubs, people were wearing suits. I mean, straight up suits. You know, like they just got off work and came straight from work to the club. And we played this music and they just didn't even know how to dance. We went home and we laughed. It was a joke to us. Back 7 months later, these same people were like hands in the air, sweaty, eyes rolling in their heads, losing it, going crazy. Overnight, they had got their interpretation of what we were doing.
It sort of took away the carpet from you. It kind of left you totally in a new space. The rhythm was in a way aggressive to you, which I didn't really discover in that sense before. Maybe it was just it was a bit of a shock, really, in a positive way. Obviously, we were thinking, "Wow, that is possible. That is something which is done," and we felt that their rough approach to technique also was a very sympathetic point, because at that point in European music, everything was tried to be as polished as much as possible and as clean and as well produced as possible. And suddenly that term well produced has changed to the opposite, whereas you actually wanted to see that the spirit is right on the record.
Techno is pure sound. It's whatever you like, you put together. It's like an abstract painting, you know. It's just whatever you put, whatever you like, it's no rules. You make your own rules up.
They had something we really loved, and we had something they really loved. We were always kind of approaching the music from a more intellectual angle, whereas that was the complete contrary in Detroit, whereas they approached the music from the middle of the body, let's say. It's no matter about the technique, it's just the idea what counts. And that's, that was, seems to be a very simple idea, but it had a big impact, and I think still going.
I think that's what changed the whole industry and then made it so big, because you had a million other people out there in Europe and all over the world that thought like that, you know, but we just did it first.
Teknomusikken er vokset kolossalt igennem de seneste 10 år. Det er blevet en kommerciel succes. Bare i England regnede en markedsanalytiker sig for et par år siden frem til, at scenen der omsat for ca. 20 milliarder kroner om året, hvis altså man regnede alt fra salg af stoffer til magasiner med. Det er blevet en industri underlagt kræfter, der ligger meget langt fra det, det var engang. Der er ikke meget havefest over teknoscenen mere. Og det er en naturlig udvikling, kan man sige. Et uundgåeligt skridt i en genres voksende popularitet.
Because we were so underground and so dark that we got left behind. Because a lot of people start stepping up and saying, hey, this is me. You got groups like everyone from the Chemical Brothers, Crystal Method. Everyone is like stepping up and they have faces to their music. Detroit people don't have faces and like proper album covers and stuff. We did a lot of things in abstract, like underground resistance. That's very abstract and very dark, you know. We were always that way from day one. And I think that's because coming from the city that we lived in, you know, that's what we were used to.
Der bliver stadig lavet masser af musik i Detroit i dag. Og som det har været igennem mange år, er selskabet Submerge samlingspunktet for de fleste Detroit-kunstnere. Det er blandt andet her, pladerne bliver distribueret ud til resten af verden fra. Submerge bliver drevet af Matt Mike fra gruppen Underground Resistance.
We just intend on, with Submerge, maintaining a direct link from Detroit artists to the world with no interruption.
We are Underground Resistance, straight from the ghettos of Detroit, and we're in the house, you know what I'm saying?
Seems that the first rush of really milestones of compositions and style directions, they have been coming out until, say, 94, 95 or something. You have the big heroes, but it seems that they are part of a, I see it as that they're part of a whole community of, say, electronic musicians, and not so much the foreheads or the forefathers anymore.
We set a standard. A standard that a lot of people don't necessarily know. Younger people don't know, and some older people don't know, but musically speaking, the original sound of this music, the blueprint, when everybody sits down to make this music, they sit down with the fundamentals that we laid down in Detroit 12 years ago.
Thank you.